July the 17th, 1945. Today I started to reread the diary I have written since the Nazis came into power in 1933. For these 12 years, this diary was my balancing pole, without which I would have fallen down 100 times. In times of disgust, despondency, and utter horror, I kept telling myself to observe and memorize. By tomorrow, everything will already look different. By tomorrow, everything will already feel different. Dispersed among the pages of my diary, there are numerous notes on the language spoken by the Nazis, to which, in part as a game, and in part out of fear of the Gestapo, I gave a fine scholarly name, L.T.I., Lingua Terzi Imperii, the language of the Third Empire, of the Third Reich. This new language, adopted by everyone in a mechanical and unconscious manner like a poison one swallows, drop by drop without even noticing it, was my only subject of study during these wretched years.
Die Gesetze des Lebens sind immer gleich und immer dieselben. Und nach diesen Gesetzen wollen wir den Aufbau des deutschen Volkes durchführen. Nicht nach Blasttheorien, nicht nach blassen Vorstellungen. Die Grundlagen unseres Lebens beruhen auf zwei Faktoren, die niemand uns rauben kann, außer wir selbst, den sie preist. In unserem Volk als Substanz von Fleisch und Blut, von Wille, Volk und Erde, das sind die beiden Wurzeln, aus denen wir unsere Kraft ziehen wollen. Wenn wir selbst dieses deutsche Volk emporführen durch eigene Arbeit, durch eigenen Fleiß, eigene Entschlossenheit, eigenen Trotz, eigene Beharrlichkeit, dann werden wir wieder emporsteigen, genau wie die Väter einst auch Deutschland nicht geschenkt erhielten, sondern selbst sich schaffen mussten.
April 20th, 1933. The word Volk, people, is as often used as salt at the table. Today is Adolf the Führer's birthday. Volksfeiertag, holiday of the people. Volksfest, festival of the people. Volksgemeinschaft, community of the people. Volksfremd, alien to the people. Artfremd, alien to the species. Jewish. For the Nazis, one is a Jew with 25% Jewish blood. If there is any doubt, the racial science expert of the Ministry of the Interior decides. HK, Hakenkreuz, swastika. I saw a child's ball with a swastika printed on it. Does this ball belong in my study of the Nazi language? School holidays. I went on a mystery bus tour with Ava. This is the fashionable thing for the petit bourgeois and for the elderly. Next to us were two old ladies, pure Aryan, who were indignant that a Jewish doctor, such a fine man, such a good family, had been deprived of his livelihood. The new law on civil servants allows me, as a former soldier, to keep my job for the time being. But as a Jew, I'm no longer entitled to set examinations for the students. poster in the students' hostel. When the Jew writes in German, he lies. Henceforth, he is to be allowed to write only in Hebrew. Jewish books in German must be characterized as translations from the Hebrew.
Das Zeitalter eines überspitzten jüdischen Intellektualismus ist nun zu Ende. Unser Durchbruch der deutschen Revolution hat auf dem deutschen Weg wieder die Gasse freigemacht. Und der kommende deutsche Mensch wird nicht nur ein Mensch des Buches, sondern auch ein Mensch des Charakters sein. Und dazu wollen wir euch erziehen, jung schon den Mut zu haben, dem Leben in die erbarmungslosen Augen hineinzuschauen. Die Furcht vor dem Tode zu verlernen, um vor dem Tode wieder Ehrfurcht zu bekommen.
To describe the organization of their large demonstrations, the Nazis use the word Aufziehen, to set up. But this word also means to wind a watch or a mechanical toy, and by extension to transform somebody into a puppet. There is also Gleichschalten, originally a technical term meaning to synchronize, to bring into line, that all associations use today to declare that they have synchronized themselves to the new regime, like automatons. The Nazi language stresses organic and natural growth, but at the same time, it is swamped with technical metaphors. This contradiction can be found in the word Betriebszelle, which is used for party cells inside companies. Betrieb, factory, Zelle, cell. Another astonishing term combining the mechanical and the organic. Ah, this new language. My work on language was a means of legitimate self-defense. There was nothing scientific about it. I randomly collected everything within reach, found in the books and newspapers, in radio broadcasts, in speeches belted out through loudspeakers, in conversations on the street, in jokes told in secret because they could lead one to jail. Third Reich joke.
Bedauere, sagt der Friseur. Darf ich nicht? Weswegen? Sie sind Jüdin. Und einem Juden wird in Deutschland bei Strafe kein Haar gekrümmt.
November 1934. Hitler's salute, also known as the German salute, has become compulsory for all civil servants. It's performed by raising one's outstretched right arm while shouting Heil Hitler. People unable for a medical reason to perform the salute with their right arm must use their left arm. My colleagues still greet me with a nod of the head, as usual, and I respond in the same way. In the offices, all the employees raise their arms to one another.
Ich schwöre Adolf Hitler. Unverbrüchliche Treue.
Unverbrüchliche Treue.
The civil service oath was sworn collectively by all university staff. I couldn't get out of it. It's no more just a question of language. The ceremony lasted less than 2 minutes. We repeated the words in chorus after a hasty recitation by the rector, eternal loyalty to the Führer and to the Chancellor of the Reich, Adolf Hitler. Then the rector shouted Sieg and the chorus bellowed Heil. He raised his arm and everyone raised their arm.
Die Märchen und Sagen der arischen Völker, besonders des deutschen Volkes, weisen diesen Geist der Verbundenheit auf, wie ihn der arische Mensch dem Tier entgegenbringt. Damit werden wir wieder auf einem Teilgebiet unseres deutschen kulturellen Lebens die Herstellung des inneren Friedens herbeiführen. Das Notwendige wird verbleiben, das Unnötige, das Schädliche, die Vivisektion und Tierquälereien werden und müssen verschwinden, sodass die für die Entwicklung unseres inneren und äußeren politischen Lebens so notwendige Übereinstimmung auf geistigen Gebieten auch hier das allgemeine Ergebnis sein wird.
Today I received a new magazine with a swastika on the cover. The magazine of the organization of the German Cat. The editorial is written in grand political style, the German Cat, as opposed to foreign aristocratic cats, in accordance with our Führer's ideas. Cat clubs are now a Reich association. Only Aryans are allowed to join. September 15, 1935. Law on German blood and German honor. German of pure blood. Mixed blood, second degree. Mixed blood, first degree. Jew. Jew. Isakovich the dentist says that in 50 years we will recognize beyond any doubt that Hitler had to come so that the Jews would become a nation again. He invited us for supper on the Jewish New Year. His head covered, he read from the Torah, a hat was put on my head too. I found it quite painful. Where do I belong? To the Jewish nation, decrees Hitler. But I feel the Jewish nation recognized by Isakovich is a comedy, and that I am nothing but a German, or German-European. Everywhere around us, there's an atmosphere of celebration. Festivals and flags, fairs, shooting contests, marksmen, regimental meetings, sports events of an SA unit, anniversary of a town, always and everywhere the celebration of the community of the people. I'm struck by the analogy with Jean-Jacques Rousseau and his times. Hitler said recently, "I'm not a dictator, I've only simplified democracy." His political model, no matter whether he's read it or not, is Rousseau's Contrat Social, of which whole passages could be found in Hitler's speeches. Return to nature, people's sovereignty. Rousseau has never triumphed to such a degree. Never have his ideas been pushed to such a level of absurdity. I am harassed by the local council. They say our garden is untidy. 3-mark fine, threat of legal action. At 8 o'clock, the council gardener turns up. He reaches for something on the ground. There's still weeds here, and here too. I have to make a report. They'll make you hire professional gardeners, and you'll have to pay them a couple of 100 marks. Me? Where shall I get the money from? You know that I've been thrown out of my position at the university. He, a good-natured, simple man who now realizes what is going on. Oh, then you're a non-Aryan. Now the context and the inescapability of the situation are clear to him. He's sorry, he says, but if he reports anything other than that weeds are still growing here, then a senior inspector will come and he loses his job. It's curious how apathetically I endure it all. Can't be helped. Cannot live normally in abnormal times. I was expelled from the university in 1935. I learnt to type and I worked relentlessly on a book dedicated to French literature of the 18th century. This book had no chance of being published, but as I was typing it, I felt that it was managing to exist outside of me. However, the Nazis deprived me of this work by forbidding Jews from using public libraries. All that remained for me to study was the language of the present day, the language of the Third Reich. Erleben, to live. The Nazis like to use this word in the sense of living something, of experiencing something. When one of their minor gods speaks, for example, you're not supposed to hear his speech, but to experience it without distance nor reserve. In the same way, every member of the petite bourgeoisie, every Nazi grocer, seizes on any occasion to give you his world view, his Weltanschauung. Schau, the vision of the mystic, of the inner eye, opposed to the exercise of reason, to logical thought, which Nazism views as its most deadly enemy. But Schau is also brought into line with the English word show, a display, a big show, a circus. This is the mechanized vision of a fascinated and manipulated eye, blinded by a light that is too bright. Romanticism and business, Novalis and Barnum, Germany and America. In the worldview of the Third Reich, both are present as inseparably connected as mysticism and pomp and circumstance in the Catholic Mass.
Und nun ein Witz, der keiner ist. Bei Prüfungen in Schulen oder bei Lehrlingen wird die Fallenfrage gestellt. Was kommt nach dem Dritten Reich? Diejenigen, die antworten, das Vierte Reich, haben verloren. Die richtige Antwort ist, nichts. Das Dritte Reich ist das ewige Deutschland.
Ewig. Eternal. The eternal people. The eternal Jew. Sometimes I tell myself, what would be different for me in the Fourth Reich, whatever form it took? Certainly I would then just feel utterly alone, because I could never again trust anyone in Germany, never feel German again. Vornamen, first names. Revolutions like to juggle with names. Under Robespierre, people were called Brutus. Under Hitler, Horst and Baldur. A new law requires Jews who do not have a clearly Hebrew name to add Israel or Sarah to their first name. I myself have to notify the registry offices and my name is now Victor Israel Klemperer. In some horror stories, a man falls under the influence of a monkey or a madman. Ecco. The Americanization of the language has increased even further. Orgy of numbers. In particular, of the number 1,000. 1,000 processions have been announced for a Reich which will last 1,000 years. Constant abuse of the superlative, borrowed from American advertising language. Everything we do is always the biggest in the world. The biggest motorway, the biggest stadium, the biggest lie, the biggest disgrace. Second of October. Munich Agreement. Czechoslovakia is carved up. England, France, and Russia do nothing. Hitler is being acclaimed as the Prince of Peace. For half a day, I thought that the time has come that I must find the courage to kill myself. Sixth of December, 1938. Withdrawal of driving licenses from all Jews. Justification: Jews being permitted to drive offends the German traffic community, especially as they have presumptuously made use of the Reich motorways built by German workers' hands. Car was our last little piece of freedom.
Hier drinnen sprechen, stehen unsere Truppen auf einer großen Linie, Press, Lemberg und nordwärts. Und in diesem Augenblick marschieren gerade seit gestern Nachmittag endlose Kolonnen der zusammengeschlagenen polnischen Armee aus dem Raum von Kutno als Gefangene ab. Wenn er 3 Jahre dauern sollte, so wird am 3. Jahr nicht das Wort Kapitulation stehen. Und am 4. Jahr wird noch nicht das Wort Kapitulation stehen. Und am 5. desgleichen noch nicht. Und auch nicht am 6. oder am 7. Das sind wir!
go or stay, go too early or stay too late. When the war broke out in September 1939, we were trying to emigrate. I'd sent out SOS calls everywhere. America, Alaska, Rhodesia, Peru, Palestine, or Shanghai. The United States consulate allocated us numbers 56,429 and 56,430 on the waiting list of emigration candidates. It wouldn't be our turn before February 1941. Perhaps it was not up to me to go, but rather to wait. I was German, and I was waiting for the Germans to come back. But where were they hiding? New words. Blitzkrieg. Lightning war. Blitzsieg. Lightning victory. One red sofa, six chairs, two old carpets, eight framed pictures, one sideboard, three deck chairs. The chaos of moving out has begun. We have been evicted from our house. The new occupant, chosen by the Nazis, is destroying the garden that took Eva years to make. He is the town's grocer. He will set up shop in our music room. We can take very little with us. Most of our furniture has to go into storage. I am burning whole bundles of letters and manuscripts. Judenhaus, Hughes House. These are requisitioned houses where all the Jews who have been evicted from their homes are brought together. The authorities have allocated us two rooms in one of these houses, a handsome, modern villa stuffed full of people who all share the same fate. Lack of space, promiscuity, chaos. A first-class concentration camp. July 6, 1940. Jews are now prohibited from leaving the Jews' house after 8 p.m. During the day, we're not allowed to enter the Grosser Garten and the other parks. In town, we are forbidden to eat at the restaurant of the railway station. We are forbidden from entering Ostra Alley, Wiener Straße, the Zoological Garden. In the Tiergartenstraße, the sidewalk on the side of the zoo is forbidden. We are allowed to cross Burgerwiese, but not to walk along it. Our mood changes daily. We count how many people in the shop say Heil Hitler and how many say just good afternoon. Yesterday at the bakery, five women said good afternoon and two said Heil Hitler, spirits up. Today, at the butcher's, they all said Heil Hitler, spirits down.
Während der Nationalsozialismus eine neue Fassung und Formung der europäischen Kultur in die Wege leitet, ist der Bolschewismus die Kampfansage des von Juden geführten internationalen Untermenschentums gegen die Kultur an sich. Er ist nicht nur antibürgerlich, er ist antikulturell. Er bedeutet in der letzten Konsequenz die absolute Vernichtung aller wirtschaftlichen, sozialen, staatlichen, kulturellen und zivilisatorischen Errungenschaften des Abendlandes zugunsten einer wurzellosen und nomadenhaften internationalen Verschwörerklique, die im Judentum ihre Repräsentanz gefunden hat.
When does an expression appear for the first time? When does it become important? When does it catch the spirit of the times? One of our neighbors in the Jew's house never spoke of his family or his ancestors, but always of his clan, Zipper, an old word from the Middle Ages, which has been reintroduced by the Nazis. I also found the word Untermensch, subhuman, in a novel by Fontana from the end of the last century. But that does not detract from its novelty. The word is new at the moment where it emerges as an expression of a new way of thinking or a new idea. Zipper and Untermensch are indeed original creations of the language of the Third Reich. February 20th, 1941. Order to sell the car within a week. A junk dealer buys it as scrap metal. I went to get the car with him. As we were pushing the car out of the garage, a few boys standing around us were shouting, "The Jew's car, the Jew's car." The next blow to be expected is the confiscation of the typewriter. It will be a heavy loss. Who can read my handwriting? The typewriter I'm using today to write out my notes was given to me by the Russian authorities from the belongings seized from fleeing Nazis. It belonged to a government department. One of its keys was modified to type the SS character. This angular character always reminded me of the influence of expressionism on the language and aesthetics of the Third Reich. Long before the Nazi SS even existed, its symbol was painted in red on electrical transformers. It is, in fact, a stylized representation of a flash of lightning. Its double line suggests increased energy. The children's formations are only entitled to one jagged bolt, a sort of half SS.
Ein sehr alter Witz des Dritten Reiches. Fragebogen des Vierten Reiches. Wann haben Sie unter der vorigen Regierung gefangen gesessen? Wenn nicht, warum?
June 14th, 1941. I have been sentenced to 8 days in prison for not respecting the blackout. On the printed form of the arrest warrant, the words "Police Headquarters" have been replaced by "The Chief of Police" and "You will be sentenced" by "I order you to be imprisoned." All official communications are in the first person, ordained by a personal god. Application of Führerprinzip, the principle of the leader.
I believe the Heimat of the Volk, the wind, the Heimat of the Volk, 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 the Heimat of the
week of the 23rd of June, 1st of July, 1941. Prison at Dresden Police Headquarters. They've taken my tie, my braces, my books and my spectacles. I'm unable to read the house rules of the police prison on a piece of card attached to the wall. I take it off the wall and move back and forth in the cell, searching for the best position, the most favorable shaft of light. After an hour, I manage to decipher the first sentence of the rules. Prisoners are forbidden to use the German salute. LTI, Language of the Third Reich.
Das deutsche Heer steht Anfang August fast 700 Kilometer tief in Sowjetrussland. Nach den Schlachten von Smolensk und Uman bereiten sich weitere große Erfolge vor. In der Westukraine ist der feindliche Widerstand zusammengebrochen. Der Weg zum Schwarzen Meer wird in rastloser Verfolgung freigekämpft. Am mittleren Abschnitt der Front, im Raume von Gomel, werden Ende August die über Dnieper und Desna geworfenen Sowjetdivisionen zerschlagen.
German losses in Russia are passed over in silence, but trickle through. By the 1st of August, 300,000 dead and 700,000 injured. In the death announcements of the soldiers who have fallen at the front, the Christian cross is replaced by a kind of torch turned upwards for birth and downwards for death. These symbols have been borrowed from the runic writing of ancient Germans, paganism and Teutomania, desire to affirm one's spiritual and blood kinship with the ancient Germans, the men and gods of the north, their solar wheels and other swastikas.
Sie wissen, der Jude ist der Urheber des Krieges, der Hetzer in der ganzen Welt. Und er lebt heute in Deutschland noch in Massen und ist damit hier der Spion im eigenen Land. Adolf Hitler hat gesagt, und zwar in einer Rede vor diesem Krieg, wenn es dem Judentum wiederum gelingen sollte, die Völker in einen Krieg zu stürzen, dann wird das Ende dieses Krieges sein, die völlige Austreibung der Juden aus Europa. Allein sind es rund 6.000 Juden, die uns die Lebensmittel wegessen, größtenteils nichts tun, sondern die Leute belästigen. Sie haben ja jetzt den Judenstern, gesehen. Und viele kommen nun entsetzt und sagen, um Gottes Willen, so viele Juden habe ich ja noch nie in Köln gesehen, wie jetzt auf einmal. Also der Judenstern war schon höchst angebracht.
19th of September 1941. The Jewish Star, made of yellow cloth, with the inscription Yuda in Hebrew-like lettering, was issued to us for 10 pfennigs. All Jews over 6 years of age must now wear it in public, clearly visible on the left-hand side of the chest, sewn on tightly. Eva will take over all the shopping. I shall only go out under shelter of darkness. Why? Because I'm ashamed. But ashamed of what? We had to forbid the Hirschel children from playing in the courtyard of the Jew's house. The children of the Aryan caretaker got used to playing with them. Aryan children and star-bearing children seen playing together can cost the Jewish parents their lives. Hiding the star, even involuntarily, is punished by concentration camp.
Weihnachtsabend. Die Glocken läuten das Weihnachtsfest ein. Ihr Klang bringt über Länder und Meere unseren Soldaten an allen Fronten die Grüße der Heimat.
31st of December 1941. New decrees for Jews. Prohibition on using public telephones. Curfew from the 24th of December to the 1st of January. We celebrated New Year's Eve downstairs with the Kreidels. Towards midnight, I made a serious little speech, so serious that when we toasted one another, my hand was trembling. I said, Hitler is the Barnum of hell. Like a true circus director, he always wants to do what has never been done before. January 21, 1942. New word. Evakuierungen. Evacuations. Every day large transports leave Berlin, Munich, Hanover to evacuate Jews to ghettos in Poland, to the east. A transport of 240 people is to leave Dresden tomorrow. Paul Kreidel, our neighbor in the Jews' house, is among them. They've sewed straps for him so that he can carry his suitcase on his back. He tells us that evacuated Jews were shot in Riga in groups as they left the train. Schleierwörter, euphemisms, Evakuierungen, evacuations, for deportations, holen, to collect, for to arrest, melden, to present oneself, for to be summoned by the Gestapo, Konzertlager, concert camp, is used instead of Konzentrationslager, concentration camp. March 17th, 1942. An Aryan friend of Eva sent us a fish's head for our cat. Fish is exceedingly rare and completely prohibited for Jews. Instructions: cook the head immediately, burn the bones. Fear of the Gestapo. In March 1942, I heard Auschwitz mentioned for the first time as the most dreadful concentration camp, where one was certain to die within a few days. In Dresden, the Gestapo were raging against those who had not yet been evacuated, increasing searches and arrests. My diary put us in particular danger. We decided to hide it with an Aryan friend. I thus had to separate myself from everything I had written since 1933 and only keep at home those sheets I was working on, which Eva would remove from the Jews' house as soon as they were finished. I also hid them as soon as I stopped writing, even for a few minutes.
Thank you. Der Mythos ist heute in über 1 Million Exemplaren in Deutschland und in der Welt verbreitet und hat naturgemäß durch diese eine Tatsache allein schon ein Stück Geistes- und Kulturgeschichte bedeutet.
I had just made a list to see how many times in the myth of the 20th century Rosenberg uses the words blood, species and race when the Gestapo arrived for the fourth time in 2 weeks. The myth of the 20th century and my sheet of notes beside it led to catastrophe. The book thumped down on my skull, they slapped me around, spat at my face and pressed down a straw hat on my head. How dare you, you Jewish pig, have the audacity to read a book like this? Leneva came back from shopping. They immediately took her bag and insulted her. Despicable traitor to your race. I wanted to come to her aid. They slapped me, kicked me out of the kitchen. Leneva defended herself very calmly. I borrowed the book. As an Aryan, I'm entitled to. The language of the Third Reich is inherently poor. Its poverty is fundamental, as if it had sworn a vow of poverty. Impossible to open a newspaper without seeing the word fanatical repeated in a nauseous repetition. Fanatical belief, fanatical will, fanatical praise, as if one had forgotten that this word was always used for something halfway between disease and crime. Beschimpfungen, insults. The lack of imagination in Gestapo insults. What a meager repertory.
Acht vergessenes Weib. Schwein. Judenschwein. Judenhure. Mäuschlumpen. Jud. Juda, Judenkanaille, Judenknechte, Judensau.
As of today, Jews and anyone who lives with them are forbidden to keep pets. This is the death sentence for our cat Mushel, whom we've had for more than 11 years. We're going to take him to the vet tomorrow, even though this is expressly prohibited, so that he is spared the fright of being taken away and killed together with the others. Efo said to me, he is playing and he doesn't know he will die tomorrow. Is there anyone looking at us at this very moment who already knows that we will die tomorrow? August 20, 1942. Frau Peek, who was to be deported to Theresienstadt, committed suicide last night. Substitutes are listed in advance for every transport. The Gestapo takes it for granted that a certain number of suicides will occur. German organization. During these last few months, I've learned that it was the prophet Ezra who codified the Jewish religion, the law, the many hundreds of prescriptions and prohibitions that bind a Jew to his God, even in the smallest of his action. The Gestapo is like Ezra. All keys, including trunk keys, are to be surrendered immediately. They're wearing us down with a steady flow of injunctions. I've listed the following. 1. We are forbidden to leave the Jew's house after 8 o'clock in the evening. 2. We're expelled from our own home. 3. Ban on listening to the wireless, on using the telephone. 4, on going to cinemas, theatres, concerts, museums. 5, on subscribing to or purchasing newspapers. 6, on using all forms of transport. 7, on purchasing goods in short supply. 8, on purchasing cigarettes. 9, ban on purchasing flowers. 10, on purchasing milk. 11, on going to the barber. 12, on calling on any kind of tradesman. 13, confiscation of typewriters. 14, of furs and woolen blankets. 15, of bicycles. 16, of deck chairs. 17, ban on having pets. 18, ban on leaving Dresden. 19, on entering the railway station. 20, on entering parks. 21, on entering the roads in the town centre and the covered markets. 22, obliged to wear the Jew's star. 23, ban on having food reserves. 24, on using libraries. 25, on going to restaurants. 26, on purchasing clothes. 27, on fish. 28, on coffee, chocolate, fruit, condensed milk. 29, special taxes. 30, monthly expenses constantly reduced. 31, shopping restricted to 1 hour a day, known as the Jew's hour. Stühler said to me, "All that writing of yours serves no purpose. The small things everybody knows, and the big things you know nothing about." I answered, "It's not the big things that are important to me, but the everyday life under tyranny, which gets forgotten. 1,000 mosquito bites are worse than a heavy blow to the head. I observe, note down the mosquito bites." It was so hot that I had rolled up my coat with the star and stood there in my jacket without the star. Two gentlemen addressed me. "We've seen you so often with the Jew's star. Why?" At that point I woke up, completely terrified. When I was young, I used to have dreams where I ended up executed by hanging in a room with a chair. Then it was puberty. Today it is the Gestapo. A card I sent to a friend in Berlin was returned to me today with the note "Abgewandert," addressee gone away with no forwarding address. Abgewandert, an innocuous word that needs to be translated as driven from one's home, assaulted, deported, sent to one's death. One can no longer assume that any Jews will return from Poland alive. ...1943 started with the capitulation of the 6th German Army in Stalingrad, followed by Rommel's defeat in Africa. I remember asking Eva, "Defeat or rout?" The never-ending enigma. How much longer?
Wollt ihr den totalen Krieg? Überhaupt erst vorstellen können. Ja. Seid ihr bereit, mit dem Führer als Phalanx der Heimat hinter dem offenen Wehrmacht stehen, diesen Kampf mit wilder Entschlossenheit und unbeirrt durch alle Schicksalsfügungen fortzusetzen, bis der Sieg in unseren Händen ist?
Vocabulary of heroism. It is necessary to be of unfailing character. Charakterisch. A new adjective created by the Nazis. Aggressive. Kämpferisch. A rare adjective, formerly used only by neo-romantic artists, but also stur, stubborn, Hitler's greatest contribution to the German language. A new word that appeared followed the defeat of Stalingrad. Anfällig, fragile, first used by Goebbels. We have been so spoiled by a long series of victories that we are a little fragile here and there. However, despite our defeats, we are still the masters. Our retreats in Russia are always planmäßig, scheduled. Our front line has never been broken because it is elastic, and the enemy offensives are only making headway im Schneckentempo, at a snail's pace, if at all.
Cäsar, Friedrich der Große und Napoleon im Himmel. Cäsar, wenn ich die Tanks gehabt hätte, ich hätte ganz Germanien erobert. Friedrich der Große, wenn ich die Flieger gehabt hätte, ich hätte ganz Europa erobert. Napoleon, wenn ich Goebbels gehabt hätte, man wüsste heute noch nicht, dass ich die Schlacht bei Waterloo verloren habe.
For me, the whole day was a potato day. I was able to get a sack full with a handcart. The sack was not tied. After two steps, the potatoes rolled onto the ground. The handcart I borrowed from the Jewish cemetery, where I had a discussion with the three gardeners who were playing cards, as usual, behind the graves. Very depressed, they expect that separation of mixed couples is imminent, which means that either the wife divorces her husband or she is declared Jewish and is evacuated with him. People have long been saying that many of the evacuees don't arrive in Poland alive, that they're being gassed in cattle trucks during the journey, and that the wagon then stops on the way where mass graves have already been dug. Strange, and to me inexplicable, how the Nazis combine public terror and secret brutality. March 2nd, 1943. About 300 of the 600 Jews who are still alive in Dresden have been imprisoned in a small camp on the outskirts of the town, awaiting their departure for Theresienstadt and Auschwitz. The transport will leave tomorrow morning. Our neighbor, Frau Voss, the Seligsons, Frau Ziegler, I count them all among the dead.
Ein ganz schweres Kapitel will ich hier vor Ihnen in aller Offenheit nennen. Es soll zwischen uns ausgesprochen sein und trotzdem werden wir nicht in der Öffentlichkeit nie darüber reden. Ich meine die Judenevakuierung, die Ausrottung des jüdischen Volkes. Es gehört zu den Dingen, die man leicht ausspricht. Das jüdische Volk wird ausgerottet. Das sagt Ihnen jede Parteigenosse. Ganz klar steht in unserem Programm drin, Ausschaltung der Juden, Ausrottung, machen wir, ha, Kleinigkeit. Und dann kommen Sie alle die braven 80 Millionen Deutschen, jeder hat seinen anständigen Juden, sagt, alle anderen sind Schweine, der ist ein prima Jude. Und so gesehen, es durchgestanden hat keiner. Von euch werden die meisten wissen, was es heißt, wenn 100 Leichen beisammen liegen. Wenn 500 da liegen oder wenn 1000 da liegen. Und dies durchgehalten zu haben, Und dabei, abgesehen von menschlichen Ausnahmeschwächen, anständig geblieben zu sein, hat uns hart gemacht und ist ein niemals genanntes und niemals zu nennendes Ruhmesblatt. Wir haben das moralische Recht, wir hatten die Pflicht, unserem Volk gegenüber das zu tun. Dieses Volk, das uns umbringen wollte, umzubringen.
For the Jews, the very idea of owning books has disappeared. Too many are floating around ownerless. Too many have been stolen, been left behind, been passed from hand to hand. Yesterday and today, Ava removed names and book plates from all the books I inherited, which in our language means that their owners gave them to me before disappearing to Theresienstadt or Auschwitz. All the belongings of an evacuee become the property of the state. Owning the thinnest booklet that used to belong to an evacuee is considered as plundering of state property, sabotage, sufficient grounds for a death sentence. Ownerless books, Jews' books. April 25th, 1943, the Willy Schluter Company, medicinal baths and herbal teas. One man stands on a wooden platform and fills the drum through a funnel, a type of hay-like fine cigarette tobacco, brightly colored granular heather flowers, like the poppy seeds on chocolate biscuits, all kinds of leaves, hazel, peppermint. The filler swallows an incredible amount of dust, which also sticks in his eyes, his nose and mouth. I am the filler. Since yesterday, I've been required for labor service from 2 p.m. to 10 p.m. every day. There are about 20 Jews employed here. Their number changes depending on shifts, illness, and arrests. The criteria that the Gestapo uses to choose its victims are more and more mysterious. Julius Berg, who worked here for 2 days, arrested on Wednesday, dead on Friday. Meinhardt, whom I'd hardly seen, arrested and dead the next day. And Conrad, a former teacher, a former soldier like me, arrested on Saturday, dead on Monday. I am like Ulysses in the cave of the Cyclops. The Cyclops says to Ulysses, "You I will eat last."
Weihnachtssingen in einem Berliner Lazarett.
1st of January 1944. The paper shortage is so severe that there are no longer calendars with pages to pull off. Instead, newspapers are now publishing a simple list of the days and months of the new year to be cut out and mounted. Time stands still. How many circulars, prohibitions and injunctions there used to be. They're very rare now. Everything has already been prohibited, and there are hardly any Jews left here. I've seen the Jews' house gradually spew out its inhabitants, and every single thing reminds me of the endless list of all those who have disappeared, who are dead, and who all had hoped to survive.
Das Geschenk des deutschen Volkes zum Geburtstag Adolf Hitlers war ein einziges Bekenntnis der Treue zum Führer, des festen Willens zum Kampf und unbeugsamen Widerstand bis zum Sieg. In der Reichshauptstadt, mit dem Wachregiment, ziehen die Berliner die Straße unter den Linden entlang. Der Führer besichtigt an seinem Geburtstag eine Reihe neuer Panzerjägerwaffen und nimmt die Glückwünsche des Reichsmarschalls und der Generäle entgegen.
June 6th, 1944, early evening. Eva brought me the news that the invasion had begun last night. She was very excited, her knees were trembling. I myself remained quite cold. I'm no longer or not yet able to hope. Krise, crisis, euphemism for defeat, is never used on its own. The crisis is always mastered or momentary. To detract attention from our defeats, it is also called Crisis of Western Humanity. Wehrmacht Bulletin of 2nd of July. In the course of a number of mopping up operations in the French area, 80 terrorists were liquidated. Liquidieren. This is a language of contempt. One liquidates people in the same way a businessman liquidates his business. In order to relegate people to the state of objects, the Nazis prefer to use liquidieren, a word of foreign origin, although the German has many words for kill. Töten, morden, beseitigen, hinrichten. First of September 1944, fifth anniversary of the start of the war. This morning, Hitler Youth Parade with drums and music, fanfares, sounding false just as all the notes of the Third Reich. If only this were the last time, and how long will it take to remove the Nazi filth from these children's heads? September 27th, 1944. Fear of bombing is so great that even Jews are entitled to passive defense drills in the courtyard of the Jews' house. We use imaginary sand and imaginary water to eliminate a phosphorus incendiary bomb represented by a food tin. Chalk circles on ground and walls represent burning phosphorus. Anyone who steps inside is dead. In the evening, a Hitler Youth appeared and summoned us to clear out the rubble from the houses destroyed by the last bombing. The summons was also addressed to a whole number of long since deported and murdered Jews. There was something wrong with the list.
Die Inschrift, die auf allen Häusern steht, LSR, soll nicht heißen, wie man glauben sollte, Luftschutzraum, sondern lernt schnell Russisch. Und nun ein kleines Lied. Es geht alles vorüber, es geht alles vorbei. Auf jeden Dezember folgt wieder ein Mai. Es geht alles vorüber, es geht alles vorbei. Erst geht der Führer und dann geht die Partei. Sie haben allen ihr Wort gebrochen, nur den Juden nicht.
On February the 13th, 1945, when Auschwitz had long been in Russian hands and the Americas were approaching Theresienstadt, we received our evacuation order, which meant an order for a death march. That very evening, the English bombers arrived and the town was submerged in a storm of fire. In the general chaos, Eva tore the star from my coat and we fled the town amidst the flow of refugees. During the following months, we wandered through Germany under false names. It was in a small village in Bavaria that I heard, for the last time, one of Goebbels' speeches.
So wie der Führer die Krisen der Vergangenheit bewältigt hat, so wird er diese bewältigen. Ich bin fest davon überzeugt. Noch vorgestern sagte er mir, ich glaube so fest daran, dass wir diese Krise bewältigen werden. Und ich glaube so fest daran, dass wenn wir unsere neuen Offensivarmeen hineinwerfen, dass wir den Feind schlagen und zurückjagen werden. Und ich glaube so fest, dass wir eines Tages den Sieg an unserer Fahnen heften werden, wie ich je in meinem Leben an etwas fest geglaubt habe.
Und am Führer Adolf Hitler, Sieg!
Heil!
Sieg!
Heil!
Sieg!
Heil!
Poor LTI. So obvious. So predictable.
Dem Faschisten werden wir nicht weichen. Schickt er auch die Kugelhagel dicht. Mit uns 10 Kameraden ohne Gleichen. Und ein Rückwärts gibt es für uns nicht.
Summer 1945. I spent all my time extracting the LTI material from my diaries, but it will result in nothing more than an essay. Otherwise I would have to read for years, and that isn't worth it. I am fed up with Hitlerism. I remember Stuhler saying to me, "Stop doing all that writing and have an extra hour's sleep. There will be more than enough historians to write about all this who will know much more than you." But in our Jew's house, there was also the woman with whom we shared our apartment, Frau Voss. Before being deported to Auschwitz, she used to storm into our room once a day and tell me, "Write that down. You must write that down." And with the same emotion, she would report on the latest house search, the latest suicide, the latest cut in ration cards. She trusted in my role as a chronicler and undoubtedly believed that no other chronicler of the era would survive this disaster other than me, whom she so often saw writing at my desk.